हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेजर टेम्परेचर जोन्स ऑफ द अर्थ। एज यू नो दैट अर्थ इज स्फेरिकल इन शेप एंड दिस स्फेरिकल शेप ऑफ द अर्थ इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द अनइवन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ हीट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। एज वी हैव डिस्कस इन द चैप्टर लोकेटिंग प्लेसेस ऑन द अर्थ दैट द रीजन located near the equator receive direct rays of the sun which spread over less area on the earth surface and therefore have greater intensity of heat. Children, as we travel further away from the equator, the rays of the sun become slanting that spread over a large area on the earth surface. Based on the heat received from the sun, the earth is divided into three heat zones of the world. And these three heat zones of the world are, first one is torrid zone or tropical zone, second one is temperate zones, and third one is frigid zone. First of all, we will discuss about the torrid zone or tropical zone. As you can see in this picture, that torrid zone lies in between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. This region receives the direct vertical rays of the sun for almost the whole year. Therefore, this zone gets the maximum heat from the sun, and this zone is also known as torrid, or we can say it as tropical zone. Now we will discuss about the second zone of the world, and that is temperate zone. Temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere, and between the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle in the Southern Hemisphere. As you all know that there are two hemispheres. First, at the top is there is Northern Hemisphere, and at the bottom Southern Hemisphere is there. Temperate zone gets the slanting rays of the sun as the angle of the sun rays goes on decreasing towards the pole. Thus, this zone experiences moderate climate throughout the year. Now, we will discuss about the frigid zone. The frigid zone lies between the Arctic Circle and the Northern Pole, and between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole. This zone is also known as polar region, since it receives the extreme slanting rays of the sun. The temperature is extremely low throughout the year. This is the reason why the polar region are generally covered with ice throughout the year. Children, in the next video, we will discuss about the life in the torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Okay, thank you.